from Universal Studio for Eddie Lyons and Lee Moran. And they asked me to come out for an interview, which I did. And, no, they said to come out to go to work. I was really going to go to work. So I went out, and the director asked me if I had my makeup. And I said no, and they looked kind of funny, and they looked at each other. And so he turned to Mildred Moore, who was an ex-Follies girl, and said, Mildred, will you take Miss London to your dressing room and give her some makeup? So I went to her dressing room, and I was putting my makeup on there, and I thank God I had this course in makeup. So I was putting it on, and I thought I smelled smoke, and I looked out of the corner of my eye, and Mildred Moore was smoking. Oh, I thought, oh my God, I'm living it up. Here I am in the movies and a woman smoking. I'd never seen anyone smoke before. And we had an awful lot of fun and we liked each other and it was warm and informal. It's not, it wasn't like it is today. The last times I have worked in pictures, it was more like a factory. It's such strict business and pressure, and about the only time we get together is at funerals. I went to Stan Laurel's, I went to Babe Hardy's, I went to Chester's, I went to Buster's, and that's the only time we get to see each other. It's really funny, and each one you go to, there are fewer of us left, and we really are a vanishing era. I don't think there are going to be many of us a great deal longer. I'm one of the youngest of the group. It'd be funny if I'd be the last of the vanishing era, wouldn't it?
And I went over to the Fox studio on Western Avenue. And I thought, well, this is the greatest studio out here. And I'm a pretty bum actress, but I'm going to try it. So I was shown into the presence of the great J. Gordon Edwards, greatest director in the business. And he had directed all the Theda Bara things for a number of years. Scholarly man. And I said, how do you do, sir? I was going to apply for something in this great Queen of Sheba picture you're making. And he seemed to grow. He just stood stretched and stretched, and I kept going, looking at him. And he said, just what can you do? I said, Mr. Edwards, I can do anything in this world that I have to do. And finally I said, I'm going to play something from Sheba. I'm going to play the love scene, as I see it, with Fritz Leiber, who is to play Solomon. And I went a few steps and I knelt what would have been before his throne. And I knelt. Then I got my petticoats up somehow, got up, and sat beside him on his throne, two gold seats, handles. And I said, you know, Solomon, I've loved you so many generations. Being beside you is just a dream reiterated. And we'll have a child. I hope it will be a boy and make another king such as yourself. And I went to New York and I came out on the stage. I was presented. I couldn't say a word. I just stood there and looked and looked and looked. And I thought, well, this is the mountaintop. This is the test. So what do you think I said? I said the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thank you, God.